Turn the stream off again. Right, then, let's get this show on the road. Right, first off, can I have Nismo, please?
I got you.
Second, Flying K-Fran. Third, Jim Boom.
Just go easy off the pit lane to start. Nine guys.
Fourth, Conor McCoy. Fifth, Solar. Sixth, Jeff. Major frame loss. Don't stay near me just for a minute. So I'm getting major frame loss again. Did I call Jeff already?
Yeah.
Mr. Alcon next. Footyard. Worn tyre. F1 racer. Any other LMPs? Right, GT3s. Andrex. Groby. Oh, you telling me to hold?
No, go.
Okay, sorry. Andrex, Groby, Picklewickle. Dangerous Ginetta. Paradiski. Nick Mido, Keeper Larden, Dabo Wabo, any other GT3s? That's all of you.
Thank you for flying King-Kodiak Airlines.
I'm getting some really serious frame loss for some reason. Oh, just as I say that, it calmed down. Happy days.
I'm still staying a marginal distance behind you.
Yeah, I would.
Just to be sure.
Yeah, I would. Well, you saw me go cannoning off last time.
Yep.
Like that. Shit. 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 Shit.
It's not a rally car. Easy.
So we're also recruiting for a new pace car driver.
I'll clean it.
our pace car driver is drunk. You don't need to warm your tires, Kodiak. From where I decided to place? Porsche course?
Yes. Basically, you dead up there already.
No, just going through our nose.
Right.
I didn't go wide again.
No. Should we wait for the others? LMPs?
Yeah, you don't need to. Yeah, no, it's fine, just crack on.
Slow down. I'm slow now. And try to get every LMPs on the straight before going away. Go away.
Alright then, Nismo, the show is yours.
Thanks, mate.
Good luck, guys.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Good luck.
See you on the other side.
See ya.
Disconnected. Right then, ladies and gentlemen, we are underway again. As Nismo then has the head of the field. He has not yet floored it. Oh, no sooner do I say that, and away he goes. He is going to... Looks like Jim Boone got the jump on Flying Kofan. Yes, indeed. Oh, look at that. Three wide coming through the first turn. Jim Boone under second. Can he hold it as they come through the first series of turns? I need to adjust my windows, but can't do so as yet, as there's far too much going on. Kofan, third. Solar, fourth. Alongside his teammate, Gunnar McCoy. There's overtaking going on up and down the field. Jeff NL, Footyard, Warm Tire, F1 Racer, and Mr. Alcon. Andrex leads the TT3 field. He's not yet underway, as they are yet to come through the final chicane then, going back up at the head of the field. And they are now stepping into... Oh, I'm getting terrible frame rate loss here. Jeff. Way! That's a weird sound glitch as well. Fantastic. Oh, as we see, I'm going to have to do something about my windows. Hold on a second. I've looked away at the wrong moment. This is overtaking going on. I know there is. Oh, someone's at the wall. It wasn't Jeff. Oh, look at that. We've got side by side. Oh, it was Conor McCoy that bounced off the wall. He's now down into seventh position. Is that Alcon up to sixth? Kutiat, Warm Tire. F1 racer back underway. Andrex has got the GT3 film now underway, with Groby in second in class, with Paddy's up to that third or 13th position. Oh, and looks like he's going to go on the inside of the Corvette. He does, into the right-hand at Tete Rouge, onto the Hernandez straight. Groby, keeper Laden in the Junetta, then ahead of Nick Mido. Nick Mido has... Come on, keep up with me. It's taking the trickle wickle. Who's got Dabo Webber for company? Dabo Webber's coming past the Ginetta, all side by side along the straight. And edges ahead, does the Cadillac. There's Hitharian, Yond, and DG to the back. He's had a terrible start. He's way behind the field. Goodness me, what happened to Dangerous Ginetta? Dear, oh dear. Oh, goodness me, what's going on here? Hitharian, Nick Mido, all going slowly. That's Yon's in that mixture as well. So there's a trouble then at... Oops, there's a wrong finger. I was at the PlayStation chicane. Yes, they're back up at the front of our LMPs. Nismo then continues to lead, with Kofan back in second position. Boom and Solar holding on to third and fourth then, as they have gone through Arnage. Heading towards the Porsche curves. I think I've got my corners right. Yes, they are indeed. Jeff NL leads. Mr. Alcon leads. Colonel McCoy leads. Futian, Warn Tire, and F1 racer. Goes to GT, sadly not able to return to us for the restart. Back to the GT3 field. Andrex still leads. Getting a break. He's breaking away from Groby, and Groby has got Pat Dieske for company, as they have along. They've gone through Mulsanne. Yes, they have. And there, that dot you see just coming through the mission, actually is dangerous to Netta. So he's had a terrible, terrible restart here. Groby leads. Oh, look at that. Very, very close. Groby running a little bit wide, but still keeping Paradisky behind him. Oh, he's run too wide at Arnage. Just manages to get back onto the track ahead of Paradisky. Back in with our leaders then. Nismo is breaking away whilst Kofan is defending for all he's worth against Jim Boone. As they are coming through Tete Rouge, back onto the Hernandez straight. Hit the overall, or about to hit the overall halfway stage in this race. Another couple of laps and we will be there. Look at that, Jim Boone's got the slipstream onto the inside of Kofan, and Flying Kofan had no answer to that, as Warn Tire and Footy had changed direction as well. There's Jeff and L, Mr. Alcon, Colonel McCoy's right with Mr. Alcon as well. There's Warm Tire, again the same manoeuvre would have been done on the first part of the straight. up into a position, then he's warm hand ahead of Footyard. And there's F1 racer as well. Andrex continues to lead there into the GT3 field. Roby then still bending off that V8 Aston. Oh, Paradiski, that's not a good entrance into the chicane for Roby then. Can Paradiski do anything about it? Almost side by side, but not quite, as they head towards the S's. Janessa of Cooper Laden is keeping contact with them. He's not fallen too far behind these two. Back onto the Anadio Straits. On the board with the Aston of Paradiski. Can he get that slipstream on the Corvette? Has he got the extra pace to do it? Slipstream. Now he's going to come out. Can he do it? Can he get that second place from the Corvette? He's got it at the moment, and that looks like it's gone to the Aston. Can he slow it down? No. Is that going to be a cutback coming from Paradiski? Yes, it is. He couldn't slow it down enough. That's going to lose him in position to the Janetta of Kiepermann and the Cadillac of Dabo Abo. So that did not go well for Paradiski. On they go then, as Jim... Oh, K-Fran, what's happened to flying K-Fran? He's lost two positions to Solar and to Jim Boom on the run down towards the Porsche curves. Flying K-Fran must have made a mistake on the entrance, the exit of Arnage, and that's given the run to Jim Boom and Solar then. As Nismo has already gone to have an 8-second or so lead. More than that. Over Jim Boom, what is now Jim Boom. So keep an eye on these three as they head towards the chicanes again. Through four chicane. The rest of the LMP field have spread out. These two are still glued together, and that flying K-Frame did not have good run onto the start finish straight. He's going to lose time on the blue Orica Nissans. So again, we find that the top four are the Orica OG Nissans. Solar keeping the pressure on Jim Boom at the moment. Slightly different lines through the Dunlop curve. Down through the chicane into the S's. The distance they've already built up over flying K-Fran. Around the Tetra Rouge. On to the Hanadier again. There's going to be very little in it as far as the top end is concerned between Solar and Jim Boom. It's just how quickly they can get there. Solar is in the slipstream. He is gaining on his teammate. Can he do anything about it? Onto the inside. But no, you can see he's topped out. That's exactly what I was talking about. There's going to be very little between these two. Solar can't just rely on the slipstream, as they're in essentially very similar machinery. Setup, of course, can be customized. They are on custom setups, and Solar this time getting in the slipstream. This is going to be his opportunity to take that second position from Jim Boom. Jim Boom's fighting him all the way. That's going to be advantage Solar. Jim Boom knew that advantage was going to go Solar's way. He did indeed back out of it. Solar didn't get a great entrance through the Michelin chicane. But on he goes and in that second position. Can he hold it? There is the view from Jim Boom's perspective. Can he close in on Solar at all? Again, no, it looks like Solar at the moment has, at this early stage in the restart, has got the pace, but we'll see how well that transpires. K-Fran is not far behind. Jeff has got K-Fran inside, well, that's indeed those next two cars inside. Mr. Alcon is keeping the pressure on Jeff and L. A little bit further back is Colonel McCoy. He's fallen through the field. Worn tyre keeps his eye on them. Footyard can keep his eye on them as well. F1 racer is quite a way back. Andrex still leads the GT3 field by 8 seconds. over the Corvette Arbor, Grobian, and oh, Jeff Hennell and Mr. Arkham have swapped position. Oh, that's why Jeff Hennell's gone off. Jeff Hennell has gone off the Indianapolis and has now gone down to ninth and his foot scout jumps through. Oh, mistake then by the Marek of Jeff Hennell, and he has lost three positions in two corners. That's where you're going then. Oh, look at that, keep him up and keep the pressure on Dabo Webber. Dabo Webber was the early leader of the GT3 field, and now the Cadillac has been challenged by the Ginetta. Kiepermann's got a little bit of extra pace, but the Cadillac's got the inside line. But can he get the running needs? Marks it on the apex. Kiepermann can't do anything about it there. There goes Grady in the Corvette. There's Cooper Larden staying in that slipstream. Can he gain enough on the Cadillac? He does indeed. He's got the momentum to do it. He's got the inside as well. That is third in class, 13th position overall to Cooper Larden. Can Dabo Webber hang around the outside? Yes, he can. Cooper Larden put the brakes on a little bit too early and handed the position back to Dabo Webber. Very nicely done by both drivers to avoid impact there. And not too far behind is the Aston of Paradiso. Larden's got it all to do again. On board again with Ginetta. Again, he's got the pace over that. Over the Cadillac. This time jumps out to the right-hand side of the Caddy, but no, he thinks better of that one. Oh, he has another look. But no, coming up to the Indianapolis. Ginetta staying a little bit tighter to the apex than the Cadillac. To Arnage. Again, the Cadillac's taking a bit of a wider exit than the Ginetta. Here he comes. Towards the Porsche curve they come. We are now over halfway. We have just gone over the halfway point of this endurance event, albeit in two stints. Unfortunately, every time I've tried to commentate on the endurance race, it has had a mass disconnect. The one occasion I wasn't there is when they didn't, so make your own judgment from there. Looking at the top of the field though, Nismo's on his own, but Solar again is having to keep an eye behind him on his teammate. Look at the lap time so far. 3:36 by Nismo. No one even close. But of course, Solar and Jim Beam are still scrapping amongst themselves. The GT3 field, Andretz 3:56.5. Not hanging around and getting straight on that pace. And again, no one is even close to it. Oh! Oh, it's jumped to me. Someone had disconnected that. How do you think the camera does that? Solar still has Jim Boone for company. Ryan Caperent is falling away from the back of those two. Mr. Alcon trying to keep in touch with Ryan Caperent. Oh, now Warren Tyre and Colonel McCoy are locked in battle as well. For sixth position. The Marek defending from the Hurricane Listen. But yeah, not too far behind either. Into the Porsche curves again. Oh no, Warren Tyre took that apex too tight and got very unsettled as a result. Yeah, curves are pretty unforgiving here. So yeah, took that one quite tight. Going past the pit entrance. Into the Ford chicane again. Oh, Dabo Webber and Groby have swapped position. Oh, and he did so into the Michelin chicane. Dabo Webber has broken free of Cooper Larden. And has also nailed Groby then. Oh, Mr. Archon, what's happened to Flying Capran? Oh, he's in the wall! Oh, no! Flying Capran is out of this race. That's soon after the start-finish line. And F1 race is just coming over the line. Oh, Flying Capran is out of this race, it would seem. He's not moving. Oh, goodness me. F1 race has come through. So he claims that 9th position. Goodness me. Colonel McCoy and Warren Tyre still very, very close in battle now for 5th position after Flying Capran's dramatic exit. Long the Hanadia again. Always looks very close, very, very close from that kind of angle when they break. It's actually that far apart, so it's nowhere near each other from the driver's perspective. It just looks much closer from the spectator's point of view. Flying Capran hasn't moved. He's still in his camping spot there in the gravel. Colonel McCoy's shaping up for a move on Warren Tyre, not before the Michelin chicane. Oh, Colonel McCoy got a snap of oversteer there, and that's going to lose momentum on Warren Tyre. And on the go again, further up the field. Jim Boom, oh, look at that! That solar going too wide at what I think. Where are we? Yeah, that was indeed the Mozan. Solo went too wide, that's going to give Jim Boone the opportunity to pass him on the inside. There he goes. We switch to the external view, side by side, heading down towards the Indianapolis, and Jim Boone backs out of it. Oh, we have just lost our race leader. We have lost our race leader. Nismo has disconnected. Are we potentially facing another mass disconnect? I certainly hope not. We have just lost Nismo. Your new race leader is now Solar. From an impressive lead, Nismo has now vanished. I hope we're not facing another mass disconnect. We've only been racing again for another 20 minutes. But we will see. We will continue until I get told otherwise. Solar and Jim Boom locked in the battle for the lead now. Has everybody elevated the position? Alcon on his own. Keep an eye on these two. Oh, Jim Boom didn't have a good run through the Corsica, through the Maison Blanche, and that has handed the advantage back to Solar. Solar able to get a little bit of a gap. And on he goes then. Eighteen laps remaining. Assuming we make it that far, of course. Mr. Alcott on his own. Oh, Warren Tyre getting a little bit too wide there. It's Colonel McCoy and Futchad in fairly short succession. Warren Tyre can't afford too many mistakes like that. He's got two cars very much hot on his heels. Yeah, and now just crossed the line. He's a little way back from the three we just mentioned. F1 racer just crossing the line himself. No way, Nismo. I just saw. Doesn't look like it's a mass disconnect there, unfortunately. Although Flying Capran is in the dust as well. Andrex then, now elevated to 9th overall. Dabo Webbo back in second place in class. He has broken free of Brody. These two field are fairly well spaced out now. Who's your internet? Oh, no way. That is a great, great shame, Nismo. Because you were away. Good night, buddy. Take it easy. Cheers, champ. still with the Corvette ahead of him. Still with Groby in striking distance. Itharian in the next Ginetta. McMido, Aston Martin. He's just got himself a car train penalty and around the outside of Tickless Pickle Pickle. In the Ginetta, he's taken that 15th place. Oh, he didn't get a good run out of Arnage. That's how close the two are. There's not a lot of room to go through there. Ginetta versus Aston. Towards the water curves they come. The Ginetta staying very close to the inside line. TPW defending his line pretty well, but that's not putting Pratnitsky off, keeping the pressure on. Through the Porsche curves, into the Maison Blanche again. Pratnitsky trying a different line to try and get a different exit. Oh, now he's jumping to the inside of the Ginetta. But no, Dickless Pickle Wiggles just got the momentum to hold him off. I don't think it's going to be long though before they start swapping positions. And Pratt is going to win for on. I don't think you're going to need that. The weather's due to stay clear for the rest of the race. Still, the Aston is nailed to the back of the Ginetta. But the lead's getting close again, and that is Groby. Race leaders are coming past Solar. Oh, it's still fending off Jim Boone just about as they come into the Dunlop curve through the chicane. Into the S's. Different line that Solar and Jim Boom are taking through that. But that's not gone well for Jim Boom. He's lost some momentum there. That's given Solar a little bit of breathing space. Oh! Solar slowed down. As soon as I say that, Solar slowed right down. I don't think he got a cut track penalty. He looks very, very slow in comparison to Jim Boom at this point. How strange. Solar suddenly let Jim Boone through. You see the gap of Jim's already opened up. Oh, and Solar nearly run too wide. That has given him a cut track penalty, I think. It has indeed. But Solar losing time, hand over fist. That's dangerous to them, you see in the background. There's quite some distance to go until they get to Mr. Arcot. Sorry, my wife has just put me over the very funny picture last time. Oh dear, professionalism's gone. Yep, shoot. Get out. Oh dear, is Flying Kid France still in the dust? No, he has retired to the pits. There is Jans, who has just had General McCoy and just come past him. Fletcher directly behind. I'm misreading my relative there. I thought my relative display was saying, oh dear, who's that that's gone off? Is that Solar? No, it's not Solar. Who's that that's gone off? Not Jeff and Al. Who's that that went off? Trying to work out who that was. Jim Boone's still going. Unless it was Solar, but he's still going. I don't think it was. Solar is in great trouble, though. Look, he's lost 10 seconds on Jim Boone. He's lost a tremendous amount of momentum. How strange. again running a little bit too wide. We can only assume the Solar has encountered a problem of some description. As he is losing time on his teammates. Seem to be able to maintain the tight lines he needs to keep the momentum. There we see, that's typically Spicker, but we've just seen coming through the shot. There's one, Mr. Alcock. There's Warnsire not far behind. The two Mareks just coming through the fort chicane. Third and fourth position. Talking, Danger Janetta has been slowly but surely making his way, catching up to the back of the field. We saw very early on he was a long, long, long way down. As he's just allowing the Mr. Archon and Warntide just to come past him. He's come past Jons whilst I wasn't looking. Hey, nosy guy, good to see you. Yes, hello, fellow teammate. Team Boom continues the lead of his race, although Solar seems to have got back into his stride again. Look at that last lap. The last lap actually for Solar was invalid, and for Team Boom for 3:38, which, as you can see, is 3 seconds off his previous best, 335.4, and Solar's 335.6. No one else in the LMP field is anywhere near that kind of pace. Absolutely incredible. No one that is left in the LMP field, I should say. Again, looking at the lap times further down the field, Andrex 355.7 in the Mercedes against Dabo's 355.9. So very close between those two, but again, still advantage Andrex. He has a 14-second lead at the front of that pack. One tyre still fairly close to Mr. Archon. There's Mr. Archon just coming out of shot. So just, what are we, about 4 seconds between the two. Field still led by Nissan's, Orica Nissan's. These two, oh, that sounded like someone clattered off the wall. Oh, is Groby in trouble? We did just hear a warning pack, but Groby is still going. Lost position to the Janetta of Cuba Laden, so it could be that Groby went too wide at the Indianapolis. But on they go nonetheless. Look at that, Solar's really got back into his drive. Close that gap to under 8 seconds, or about 8 seconds now. Was over 10 when Solar seemed to be getting the worst of his problems. That seemed to have remedied it. And underway, and also one time, Mr. Alcon. Close together, perhaps. That is Tickle Sprickle Wickle in the Janetta. That is in between two, as well as Paradisky in the Aston, you see, just further on the road. Let's jump back to the battle between Cooper Laden and Brody then. That's fairly close together. The Janetta holding on to that 11th spot ahead of the Corvette. Oh, Groby's gone too deep. He's gone too deep into the Dunlop curve, and he has got himself a cutback penalty for his trouble. That's advantage well and truly handed to Cuba Laden in the Janetta. And there you see the race leader Jim Boom coming up behind the Corvette. Just 7 seconds now separates the two Oricas at the front. And an easy pass then for Jim, the inside of the Corvette, as they come onto the Hernandez Street once again. Who else can we find? Let's jump back up to one tire. There is the gap between himself and Colonel McCoy, and that is Picklewickle. Oh, one tire getting very, very out of shape. I think it was contact between him and the Ginetta as well. Ooh, big impact there on the rumble strip, but on he goes anyway. We've lost a little bit of time to Colonel McCoy because of the Ginetta, but that is the nature of endurance racing, or mixed class endurance racing, I should say. Less than 2 seconds separates Warm Tire and Colonel McCoy. There you go, you see Warm Tire's gaining, but it would not be enough before the PlayStation chicane. But Warm Tire, oh, well, you are allowed to go out there. That is a demon part of the track. Looked like he was going to have a decent run on Colonel McCoy at that point, but still gaining on the. I think that's a missing their head. Yes, it is. That's going to be three wide potentially, as that is Paradiski staying well out of the way of these two LMPs. Jump on board the Warm Tires. He's had a much better run through the Michelin chicane into the slipstream of the Nissan of Colonel McCoy. It's going to give Warm Tire the momentum. Oh, and nearly pushed into the barrier by Colonel McCoy, then into fourth position goes Warm Tire. Can he hold it at the Multan? Almost side by side going through the Multan turn. And into fourth position then goes the Marek of Warm Tire. Nice clean maneuver there. But Colonel McCoy's not done with him yet. Colonel McCoy's turn as the sun begins to set. Here at Le Mans. Colonel McCoy is keeping that pressure on. Now going to the right hand side. Outside before Indianapolis, but Warm Tire's got the momentum. Oh, but he didn't get the run. That was a very bumpy entrance towards Indianapolis, but he had the inside line. Maintains that fourth position for now. Grenache. And McCoy making his presence known to the match. On board again with Colonel McCoy. Mac definitely has the pace at the moment. Can Warm Tire maintain that gap between himself and Colonel McCoy before the Porsche curves? It looks like he can, and the camera is lost as it's looking back at Fityad and Paradiski. There we go, that's better. Oh, as both of them run a little bit wide coming into the Porsche curves. That is Nick Mido coming up to. Oh, that's caught. Warm Tire a little bit out there. And again, there's nothing that anybody could have done about that. Colonel McCoy had to take very close to the inside line there to avoid impact with the Aston. Through they go. Through the Porsche chicane once again. And on to another lap. Colonel McCoy keeps that pressure on the Marek, keeps that pressure on Warm Tire. Two-thirds of the race is complete. We are fast heading towards the final 10 laps. Flimsy 14 to go. Oh dear, the Marek did not get a good run through Tetra Rouge, and up into fourth position is Colonel McCoy. Oh dear, Warm Tire are going to have to chase Colonel McCoy right the way down. He's lost a tremendous amount of time. I wonder if Warm Tire got a cut track there, because it's nearly 5 seconds he's lost. Warm Tire going to have to chase Colonel McCoy down again. Back over the front then, Jim Boom has certainly found his pace again. As he's coming to the back of Andrex. It is a colossal time, 25 seconds or so back to his teammate. So Solar either has had a problem somewhere, or his problems have returned, and there's Dabo Wabo in the Cadillac. Or Solar's had some trouble somewhere. Look at lap times, yeah, 3:35. Oh no, it was the invalid lap for Solar last time around. Mr. Alcom? That's not Mr. Alcom. That's Mr. Alcom. That is Groovy. You see, in the Corvette, he's lost the back of Keeper Laden. The Ginetta able to get some distance. Third in class at the moment. Still quite a while to go. There's Kenan McCoy. There's Montaigne. They're just getting around Tharian. His brightly coloured Ginetta on board with Montaigne. You can see how he's closed that gap down to just under 2 seconds now. Will Montaigne be able to get that pressure back on for that fourth position? So come through Indianapolis again. Class is currently being led by this man. It is Andrex in the Mercedes, who has been the main dominant force in the GT3 class all race long. Mainly was led for a big period of time in the first half of the race by this man, Dabo Webber. Hey, advice guy, good to see you. How come you're not in front of the camera? Back under warm time, he's still keeping that pressure on Colonel McCoy for the fourth place. I thought one time was spinning there, but as it was, he was just throwing the nose of his car into the gap. And look at that, he's really got the momentum on Colonel McCoy. He's going for the inside maneuver, and Colonel McCoy jumps into the pits then. That makes the pass that little bit easier for warm time. Into fourth place he goes. Keeper Laden and Dabo have just swapped position. What has happened there? Dabo's in the pits, that's what's happened. Oh, I need some excuse for this guy. Good to see you in the stream anyway, good sir. Which footy had in? Jeff is in, so we're seeing a flurry of. Oh, I see. You're always welcome in the stream, though, good sir. That's Jeff in. Kurtiad is in as well. There goes Dabo Webber. As we see Warm Tire coming up to the back of Groby. We have got no particular close battles at the moment. So let's just check in with our race leader. Here he is. Continues his way. He's coming up the Malzahn, isn't he? Yep. So on his own to the tune of 23 and a half seconds or so. Over his teammate Solar. There he is. That is Andrex in the background, you can see. The biggest thing we need, White Sky, is these damn mouse disconnects to stop. That would be the best thing we can have, but sadly, we don't have your awesomeness to prevent that from happening. Mr. Alcom just coming out to the Malzahn himself. Warm Tire on the outside of Keeper Laden. We can but hope, Mosigari. We can but hope. Oh, look at this. Jeff and Colonel McCoy now battling for fifth position post pit stop. Whoops, and that's Dangerous Ginetta running a little bit too deep at the PlayStation chicane. Let's jump on board with Colonel McCoy. Let's see how close that is. And it's going to be gaining, and Jeff trying to get out. Trying to get Colonel McCoy out of the slipstream and jumps back to the inside line. Colonel McCoy still got that slipstream onto the outside there. Oh, the big button's going to be the inside for the Michelin chicane side by side. And still, Jeff maintains that position. Oh, but Colonel McCoy had a much better run on the exit of the Michelin chicane. And he's going to claim that. Well, he already has claimed that fifth position. Jeff jumps behind him now. Can Jeff get the slipstream before the Malzahn? It doesn't look like he's going to. both of them running a little bit deep, but they'll get away with it. And on they go then. So Jeff now down into sixth position. Gunnar McCoy claims. Oh, is Jim Boom in the pits? Yes, he is. We have a new leader then. Solar has taken the lead of the race with 12 laps to go. Solar's around there somewhere. There he is. That's a pretty quick pit stop for Jim Boom then. Mr. Alcon is in as well. He's just come into the pits as opposed to getting out. Yep, there we go. So he's just getting to his pit stall. Warm Tyre is in as well. So the top four all pitted. There's Andrex is in. The lead of the GT3s has come into the pits. McCoy. There's Jeff NL. There's Gunnar McCoy already getting a bit of a gap then to Jeff. Butchad completely on his own. That's his F1 race. As he's gone wide of the miles line. Right, keeper Larden then, who not pitting, has taken the lead of the GT3 class. Not by a great deal though, only about 10 seconds or so, about 9 seconds rather, over this man Groby. There has been a few incidents in this race between the classes, you are absolutely right. Andrex is still in. Oh no, he's not, he's out now, so Nick might have just come past him for 12th. That's going to be the last pit stop Andrex makes. On he goes then. Oh, that's one time Conor McCoy. Just swap positions then. What appeared to be swapping positions. As Conor McCoy is now stuck behind Paradiski, ready to try and get out of the way. Conor McCoy launching himself on the inside of the Aston. Warren Tyre's got Jeff still behind him. Yes, because Andrex is wearing Fred A. skin. Jeff and out. Couple of seconds down. Who else can we see? Nick Minder and Paradiski are a bit close to one another. Let's have a look. There they are. That's actually Andrex that's directly ahead of, Nick Mario and Andrex are close together as the Mercedes has just overtaken the Aston again. Andrex has about, what has he got? A minute or so of distance ahead of him to regain the lead. But of course, we are assuming there are going to be pit stops for Keeper Larden, Groby and Hitharian. Sun's getting quite low in the sky now. It's pretty blinding, staring the sun straight in the face. Keeper Larden coming up to Indianapolis. On his own to the tune of about 7 seconds of green. He is gaining on Keeper Larden surely and slowly. Let's have a look at some lap times again. Ah, Solar was coming in, as was to be expected. Fastest lap of the race still lies with this man, Jim Boom. 335.4. A couple of tenths away from Solar's time. A couple of tenths ahead, rather, of Solar's time. Here comes Jim Boom to retake the lead. Assuming Zola hasn't come out yet, and indeed he has not, so Jim Boom retakes the lead of the race. Zola's having quite a long stop. Surprisingly so for the stage in the race. Mr. Alcon turns around the Porsche curve somewhere. There he is in the Merrick, pressing on to try and close that gap now. Zola, there he is, Zola then, and out he comes, and that has dropped him 40 odd seconds down from Jim Boom. Goodness me, over 40 seconds indeed from Jim Boom. That's quite a big gap. But on we go. 11 laps remaining. here at Le Mans. Anything can happen in the remaining time. Mr. Alcott remains in that podium position. He's got 30 seconds or so between himself and Solar. Bennett McCoy, 10-ish seconds down from Mr. Alcott. And almost equidistant back is Jeff NL. That's Andrex UC. That is Warn Tire. Ooh, Nick Mido. What's going on with him? Dabble Web is in. Where's Nick Mido? That is Nick Mido. Beg your pardon. I thought that was Dabble. That looks like a... That looks more like the Caddy than it does the Aston. The Nick Mido is in then. And that was Picklewickle in the Janetta coming in as well. There is Dabble Web. With... He's right ahead of him. Danger Genetic comes past TBW and Nick Mido as well. The 55.958 is Dabo's best. And 354.875 of Andrex. Oh, we see, got the wrong click. Dabo Weber jumps on the outside of the Aston Martin, flies past Paradiski. Easy overtake for Dabo. Takes second in class. No, beg your pardon, that's fourth in class. Fifth in class, Keeper Laden still leads. Keeper Laden still hasn't pitted yet. Frankly, he's going a long way. Dabo then up to 13th place from Paradiski. Warn Tire and Jeff and Elle have swapped position as they've gone through the Michelin chicane. Oh, and Jeff has had a big snap of oversteer on the exit of the Michelin chicane. And through goes Warn Tire then. That one goes to the Marek. Now let's just jump back to Paradiski. There he is in 14th position. Still chasing that Cadillac of Dabo, trying to regain that position. Jump on board with the Aston. He's not really gaining on the Caddy though. Not gaining on the Caddy at all. We come up to the Malzahn. Oh dear, Paradiski's gone very wide. That's a rather unusual way to come into the Malzahn. On he goes. Let's jump up to Keeper Laden. He's coming through the Porsche curbs. The camera would kindly go where I'm telling it to. There he is. Keeper Laden currently leads the GT3 field. Taking over from Andrex when he pitted. Still yet to pit that Janetta himself. Does he do so this time? That is Mr. Alcon in third position coming up behind him. Easy pass for Mr. Alcon that time, and still Keeper Laden goes on. 10 laps remaining. Roby continues, and that is Conor McCoy right behind him. Can recall his opportunity. There he goes. Tharian is continuing to run on the Janetta. Oh, beg your pardon. No, he wasn't. He has decided to come in. That is going to allow Andrex. There he is. To take that 11th spot. Mercedes, through he comes. So Andrex has 28.1 seconds then. To gain on the Janetta of Hetharian. On the Gorvet of Groby. So the name hadn't changed. I was looking at Hetharian's name. No other particularly close battles at the moment. Paradiski is also in. The GT3 field in there is Danger Janetta. Where is he? He's just coming up to Leading forward to Kane, is he going to jump around this unit iron as well? Kodiak hasn't moved, Hatarian hasn't moved, so yep, that position's going to go to the Corvette of Dangerous Nenser. After a disastrous restart, he has slowly but surely been making his way through the field. Let's see how far he can go. Hendrix then. With quite a bit of time to make up to Groby, but Groby and Kiepeladen ahead of him have not pitted. Believe they've pitted since the restart, so it would certainly is very likely that they will pit at some point soon. As Roby's got one tyre coming up behind him, and there we hear Kiepeladen, there he is coming up to the Malzahn. Excuse me. Where's our leader? Here he is, Jim Boom. Into the end of the Porsche, end of the Maison Blanche. Toward the Ford chicane once again. Has been, since passing his teammate, he has been pretty unchallenged since. We have less than 10 laps remaining then, here at Le Mans. Let us hope for no further disconnection in that period of time. So hold on that, just coming through the final chicane himself, Mr. Alcom. Ooh, weird graphic this stuff. Just coming through the Porsche curves. Conor McCoy, just doing the same. One tyre. That's a weird look on that piece of track there. There he is, with Kiepeladen directly ahead of him. It's Pergisky and Nick Minder have just swapped position. And that is why. Side by side into the Michelin chicane. Pergisky's got himself a cut right, so he's allowed Nick Minder back up into 15th position. Oh, goodness me. After chasing him down, close to up, Mr. Alcon on one tyre. Now, oh, no! Who's that facing the wrong way? It's Mr. Alcon. He's not facing the wrong way. He's pulled over to the side of the track. Mr. Alcon is out. Oh, goodness me. I was getting nervous when we had a disconnection. We have lost Mr. Alcon then from third position. Another victim of the endurance race from the NMP class. So everybody from Colonel McCoy down, the elevated one. And that's Andrex and Groby swapping position. That's why Groby is in. So Andrex then up to second in class behind the determined little Janetta of Kiepeladen. Dabble Wabbo's come past Groby as well. There's Groby, there he is. Where's DG? Just coming through the Porsche curves. Ooh, Maison Blanche. And Groby's going to come out in 11th position, fourth in class. Andrex just coming onto the Renardier as Kiepeladen has come through the high station at chicane. I don't think I've actually seen that illumination on the track before. Interesting. Never actually noticed that before. Not sure whether it's supposed to do that, but there you go. The track glowing bright orange. Bright orange, rather. How are the lap times looking? 3:56.7 for Andrex. 4 minutes for Kiepeladen. So Andrex is really beginning to reel in that Janetta. Does he have enough laps Assuming Kubladen doesn't pit again, does he have enough half to close that gap down? We will see. He does have enough time just about. 4 seconds a lap over 9 laps. 36 seconds, with just shy of 36 seconds again. Assuming that Kubladen's pace is likely to continue to drop on very, very, very worn tyres. Here's Kvyat right behind Kubladen then. Kubladen goes high to allow the LMP through. Very nicely done. Through Arnage and on he goes. Nick Maido is still pretty close to Paradiski. Saw Paradiski getting that contact penalty earlier. Well, Paradiski certainly got his foot down. There you go, 3:57 for Paradiski and 4 minutes for Nick Maido. Okay, they're best times as opposed to last times, but it's quite a pace difference between those two Astons. Like Nick Maido has an answer though. No, Paradiski's got past him. Maido looks like he's going to have to settle for that 15th position. Thankfully, it doesn't look like we have any further disconnections after Mr. Alcott, so all seems well for now. Pick up the keeper. He has not pitted, so I think it's a fair bet to say that Kubladen is going to the end of the race. What was his last lap? 3:59. Where is Hendricks? There he is, just coming through the final chicanes. What is his lap time going to be? Let's have a look. And what is 3:56, so another 3 seconds off the gap. That is 28 seconds. It's not going to be enough. Hendricks is going to rely on a mistake from Kubladen. Oh dear, that's not going to help you though, Hendricks. Too wide out the Dunlop curve. But on he goes nonetheless. Hendricks is going to rely on a mistake from the Geneta of Kubladen to try and regain that class first. Kubladen just has to stay with his rhythm and that class victory will be his. Race leader Jim Boom, he's gone through Arnage. There's not really anybody else that's closer than he was except Paradiski and Nick Maido. But even they are getting further apart as Paradiski is pushing on and building up a little bit of a gap between himself and his Aston Martin brethren. As they come through Maison Blanche towards the Fortune. Oh dear! That's Dangerous Janetta that's getting on out of shape and going into the pits this time. Is that a last minute change of heart by Dangerous Janetta, I wonder? That's damage on the front of the Corvette. So he's had an argument with something. Just taking myself a drink. Maido is still pretty close to Paradiski. Whilst Paradiski was looking like he was putting away, Nick Maido getting back into his rhythm again. He's closing back in on that last. Even though Paradiski last time around did have the quicker lap, we will see how that battle transpires. 7 laps to go. So the gap has most certainly gained this time. And there you see race leader Jim Boom coming up behind. Well, you can't quite see it from that camera angle, but he's closing in on Nick Maido. Put another lap on the Aston. There you see how Paradis is able to build up a substantial lead now over 15th place Nygmido. There goes race leader Jim Boom back on the Hernardier straight. And my angle done half last a long time. Let's check back in with Kupo. Where is he? There he is. Through Maison Blanche again. Does he pit or does he not? Yes, he does. Kiefer Laden has decided not to run to the end of the race. And that is going to hand the class lead back to Andrex then. Unless this is the quickest GT3 pit stop, or endurance GT3 pit stop I have ever seen. Let's stay with... There is Andrex. Going through Maison Blanche then. Predictably, the Mercedes does not pit. Through the Ford chicane. Laden's in his pit stall. There goes Dabo as well, I think. No, it was Jons. It was the wrong caddy. There is Andrex. He's going to take that race lead as Kiefer has not moved. A race lead rather class lead. That is back in the hands of Andrex. I was pretty sure that Kiefer was going to go to the end. That's a long pit stop for this late in the race. And Dabo's gone through as well. It's 9 seconds between, sorry, 11 seconds rather, between the caddy and the Mercedes. See what the lap times between the two are. An invalid lap by Andrex, 3:56 by Dabo. With F1 racer just behind him. And up a little bit on the exit of the Tetra Rouge. Racing going to the inside, and past he goes. Andrex then, back in the lead of the GT3 class with Jons straight ahead of him. Through the A station chicane, going to be an easy pass for Andrex to do. John should relinquish this one as it is a lap by a same class car, and there he goes. And it's no doubt getting a bit of slipstream on that backstrike as a result. The race leader has just come over the line again. 6 laps to go. Absolutely flawless performance by Jim in this stage of the race. It was pretty hot in the first half of the race as well, but leads by a minute, over a minute, at the head of the race. So now he's in. He's in the pit again. Very surprising. Is that going to hand? Where's Kenny McCoy? There he is. So we have a battle then for second position between Solmar and Colonel McCoy, with Dangerous Janetta right in between the two. Hello, Min Vasco. Good to see you, sir. I'm all right. I'm actually getting to the end of this endurance race, so good of you to come along. I hope you're well, sir. Hope everybody is well that's watching the stream here tonight. We thank you for enduring with us through the disconnections, through the problems. Colonel McCoy with his eye on the prize of second position. You're not going to gain enough before the PlayStation chicane. Too far back to make an attempt unless he gets a great run down this straight before the machine chicane. Just jump on board. board again with Colonel McCoy. Gaining ever so slightly on Solar, but it's not going to be enough before the chicane. Through they go. That wasn't, didn't look a good run through that chicane for Solar. So again, looks like Solar's beginning to struggle again. And Colonel McCoy could well benefit from it. That through, that was Tiffany's Pickle Wiggle that just came past the shot. On board with Colonel McCoy, he's certainly got the pace. Can he get into the Mozan? He thought about it, but thought better of it in the end. Last Mozan down towards Indianapolis. Not a heavy braking zone at the Indianapolis, and Solar had a better run through the Mozan than Solar. Then Colonel McCoy, rather. Colonel McCoy just beginning to close in Solar again. Oh dear! That's Picklewickle that's on the side of the road. Picklewickle's had a spin in his Ginetta at the Indianapolis. Not allowing Dangerous Ginetta to close in a bit on him. The Ginetta back on his way again. Again with Colonel McCoy. Keeping that slipstream going. Things better of it before entering the Porsche curves, but that's made Solar go a little bit wide. That's compromised his entrance. But he's got back into a rhythm. Ooh, sounded like someone hit the wall there. Five laps to go. Five laps remaining here. Battle well and truly on for the remaining podium positions. Let's see what the lap times were between these two. 3:57 for Solar, 3:38 for Colonel McCoy. That's actually his best of the race. Best of this half of the race, at least 3:38.068. So Colonel McCoy, that's allowed him to close right up on Solar. Can he do anything about it? Oh dear, that wasn't a good run through the Dunlop curve at all. And the following chicane, that's given a few seconds back to Solar then. They enter back onto the Hanardier straight. About 5 seconds indeed between the top two now. Can Colonel McCoy close that back in again? He's had the pace previously to do it, but we will see whether he can do it this time. Whether we can do it again or not. I'll get the right words out soon. There's Jim Boom coming up to Ibelarden. Fourth in class after his pit stop. Jim Boom a little bit caught up behind the Ginetta, but Jim knows full well he doesn't have to do anything silly to maintain that gap. Nearly a minute and a half. Whoops, runs a little bit wide at Arnage, but with over 70 second lead between himself and Solar, I think he can afford a little bit of mishap here and there without throwing it into the wall, of course. Andrex continues to lead the GT3 class. Sparking away underneath the guard. Dabble Webbo, second in the GT3 field. Very similar pace between the two. 3:57.6, 3:57.9. No real gain there by Dabo. He's going to have to gain it 2 seconds a lap for the next five if he wants to pressure for that class win. There is Jim Boom coming up behind Groby. Groby has the GT3 third place podium at the moment. that crossing of the line signifies 4 laps to go. Ola on his own. The number 4 is there somewhere. And there he is. Oh. I think he caught that rumble strip a little bit hard. Can we see Solar from Kanamoko's perspective? Oh, just. Yeah, we just saw the brake lights there. That is Solar just ahead. He's going to have to get his foot down if he wants to close that gap back up again. That is Nick Mido ahead of Solar. That could help close that gap up. Worn tyre, we haven't seen much of him for the latter part of this segment of the race. Holding fourth is, let's see what the time is between him and third. It is 16.9 seconds. Lap time 3:39 against 3:40 against 3:36 for Solar. 3:41 for Jim Boom. Jeff NL caught out behind Dickens Picklewiggle with Footyap right with him now. Two of the lap times are so invalid lap for Jeff, 3:41 for Footyap. No, Footyap is now going to be able to put pressure on Jeff for that fifth then. We go through the four chicane. Beginning to fall. Drew Dunlop. Through the Tetra Rouge. Onto the Hennadier. Marek chasing Marek. On board with Footyap. Izzy Ganey on the Orange Marek. Not particularly. Charging down towards the PlayStation chicane. He is gaining a little, but not at a massive rate. PlayStation chicane. But yeah, he's right with Jeff now. On board again. Jeff is able to get on the gas a little bit earlier, but Footyap then starts to build up the momentum again. Oh, that is actually quite sickening when watching a keyboard or pad player like that. Oh, Footyap looked like he had a better run through the Michelin chicane. He was able to stay a bit closer to Jeff that time around, I think. Very similar. Into the Mulsanne. Footyap keeping pace with Jeff, keeps the pressure on. Jeff will know he's there, and just one simple mistake will allow Footyap through. Just 6 LMP runners remaining in this race. Rest of the field from Andrex down to Jans are all GT3 runners. Oh, both cars actually running a little bit wide at Indianapolis. Footyap slightly more so. That's going to give a bit of breathing space to Jeff. That's handed the advantage back to Jeff, I think. All needs to go. 3 laps remaining. This kind of pace, that is about 11 minutes to go. Through the Porsche curves, through the Maison Blanche for these two. Footyap didn't get a good run through there. Jeff got a much better run to give himself a bit more breathing space over the chasing Marek. into the forward chicane again. Oh, blimey, that's a lot of twitching going on for Footyard. Lap times again, 340, 341, so Footyard, whilst able to close in on Jeff, isn't able to keep the pace he needs to keep the pressure on the Dutchman. Sounds like an Aston, that is indeed, it's Paradiski and McMino, or Paradiski rather, that can be heard in that particular shot. There he is, just disappeared on the top of the shot. GT3 Class Eater Andrex. Coming through Indianapolis himself. 20, over 20 second lead of this man, Dabo Abbo. There's Dabo himself comes up to the Indianapolis. There is Roby in the Corvette. This has come through Mozam. Field. We've had the entire field spread out quite a while. Oh, no, saying that, Footyard. Back on Jeff's case then. Jeff and Els made a mistake somewhere, and Footyard is looking to capitalise on. On that back straight then, Footyard. What can he do? Heading down towards the Michelin chicane. Oh, Footyard's going to go over a dive on the inside. Not quite. But Footyard could get a better exit. Jeff had a compromised entry into the Michelin chicane. Not done yet. Footyard now in the slipstream again. He's going to go to the right. That's going to give him the inside for the Malzahn. If he can stay in that position. Oh, he's going to go for it. Oh, he's going to go too deep. Jeff NL's retaking the position. Yes, he has. But yeah, couldn't quite get the car slowed down enough. And back into sixth position he goes. Lovely driving by both of them. Excellent recovery by Jeff. Down to the Indianapolis again. Oh, Footyard's gone for a tighter line there. Doing what he can to shake that persistent Brit off his tail, but Footyard's having none of it. That's Nick Mido up ahead, you can hear. There he goes, you just saw the Aston disappear out of the shot. Down towards the Porsche curbs. We are on the penultimate lap then, or the leader. Lead two are on the penultimate lap. But yeah, keeping the pressure. Oh dear, that wasn't a good run for Jeff and Al through the Maison Blanche. Big him up, that's the Maison Blanche. It was the Porsche curves that Jeff didn't have a good run through. Into the four chicanes again. Could Nick Mido play a part in this particular battle? On board again with Footyard. Mido stays out of it. He comes through the Dunlop curve once again. Ooh, didn't look like Footyard had a good run through that though. Jeff and Ed had a bit of a better line through that. Through the S's. Detre Rouge. Onto the Hanardier. But he has too far back to make advantage of a slipstream. Down towards the PlayStation chicane again. Let's just see where our race leader is. He is at the Indianapolis curve. Solar is on his way to the Mulsanne. Adam McCoy's just gone through the Michelin. Montai is on his way up to the Michelin. Oh, Jeff are now trying to jump out of the way of Futiat, or trying to prevent Futiat from using the slipstream. Futiat is not giving up on that orange Marek. Oh, blimey, that's quite seasick inducing. No disrespect to Futiat, of course, but from a spectator's perspective, you're not expecting, you're not knowing when the twitch is going to happen, therefore it can be a little bit travel sick inducing. But yeah, this could be his opportunity to try again at the Maltan for that fifth position. Is he going to try it? He's gone on the inside. No, he thought better of it this time. Oh, but he went for a wider entrance. Is that going to give him the exit he needs? They head towards the Indianapolis. Okay, that's not me that's using that camera. That's the that's the DV camera that's done that one. Down towards Indianapolis again. Not really an opportunity there. Oh dear, that's very wide for Jeff Hanel. Into the Arnage. Near identical line there. Only one real way of taking it. It looked like Futiat had a snap of oversteer there. Jim Boom has started the final lap here at Le Mans. Just one lap remaining. Futiat is running out of time to try and get that position. Jeff is running out of time to defend it. Oh, a bit of a different line being used by the two. Ah, hey, Morvik. Oh, is that a cut right by Futiat? It is. He took one of the turns through the Porsche curves too tight, and he got himself a cut track penalty. Oh, goodness me, unless Jeff makes a mistake. And Futiat's gone in. Why are you going in the pits at this point? Does he not realise there's only a lap left? Oh, my word. Well, the person behind him, position-wise, is actually Andrex, and there's two laps difference, so I suppose he's not going to lose anything. Let's follow our race leader then. That is Dendrick Jannetta we see. Into the Mulsanne for the final time in this endurance event. The field pretty spread out now. Bit of slipstream behind the Corvette. Past he goes. Towards the Indianapolis. It's a shame we didn't get the changing weather that we were hoping for. But that's the nature of the game, unfortunately. On we go towards the Porsche curves once again. That's really eerie when you can't hear any cars. Not helped, of course, by that ridiculous sound glitch. Through the Porsche curves. Oh, it looks like Jim Boomers are going to take off there. He leads by nearly a minute from his teammates through Maison Blanche. Into the Ford chicane for the final time. Here is your race winner here at Le Mans. It is the Arca Nissan of Jim Boom. A good old celebration to himself, and why the devil not? What a win. What a performance. Danger Jannetta's crossed the line. Here is second place Solar coming through the Porsche curves. That is Dabba Wabba. You just see ahead. So Andrex has just crossed the line. Andrex is the winner of the GT3 class. You can find him. There he is. The winner of the GT3 category is the Mercedes Armandrex. Second isn't Dangerous Ginetta. It is the Cadillac of Dabba Wabba. Followed very quickly by the Orica Nissan of Solar then to take the second podium spot for LMP. Here comes Connor McCoy to take the final podium spot for the LMP class. All three of the top spot are Orica Nissans. Very nicely done. Well done to you, Connor McCoy. Here comes Warm Tire in the lead. Merrick bouncing over the dirt. Fourth position to you as Keeper Laden has just crossed the line, as Groby did as well. I actually missed Groby crossing the line. So your podium positions for the GT3 class: Andrex, Dabo, and Groby. There is Groby in the Corvette. Here comes Jeff in the Merrick, surviving his battle with Footyad to claim fifth position through the Ford chicane once again. And over the line he comes. Flash the lights, and why not? There is Footyad. That's Hitharion and Nick Mido further down the road. There is Nick Mido. You just see Hitharion has just crossed the line. He's claimed that 11th spot. Here comes Footyad. Over the line he comes. Andrex is done. Dabo, Groby, Kibo. Hitharion's already back in the pits. Nick Mido is over the line. DG's already over the lines. Jons is way out there on the back straight. Here comes Paradiski through the Ford chicane. And over the line he comes to claim 13th overall. There's DG, there's Jons. Here comes Picklewickle into the Ford chicane to claim 14th overall. And that is your field, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for sticking with us through the trials and tribulations. This spells the end of the first season of the Endurance League. Yes, I know the overlay still says Pro League. I never changed it. Ladies and gentlemen, my name's been King Kodiak, and I thank you so much for sticking with us through thick and thin. And keep an eye on the forums. There will be a sign-up in a few weeks' time for the Endurance League Season 2. But until then, we'll catch you right here for more AOR action. Thank you very much, and good night.